we hand over to Frankie, our MPD patron and president of the Natural Voice Network and folk legend. Take it away, Frankie.
Thank you, Sue. I really, to say, I refer to you as Saint Sue, because without you, I don't think we could ever do these events. So welcome, everybody, for musicians for Peace and Disarmament, and what a time it is to have such a plea. So I'm so glad that you've been able to come. And I have to make announcement about two changes to explain a couple of items, because the reason that we chose, MPD and I chose this particular date for this concert, was because this week there was supposed to be the further joining and ratification of the proliferation, I have trouble with that word, proliferation of nuclear weapons, the United Nations treaty that came in last year, January the 22nd. We will touch on this issue again a bit later. And hence we thought, oh, let's call the concert celebration for peace. But very sadly and tragically, since then, the world has changed, and so it's striving for peace now. Just to explain why there has been that change, because we started planning this months ago. And so I've been told that there will be more countries ratifying the treaty in June. It's been put off from this week to June. So listen out for that, because that's a big shift. And also I will talk a little bit more about Musicians for Peace and Disarmament later on in the course of the event. Sadly, one of our people due to be performing for us, Jim Woodland, at all well, and so sadly he dropped out yesterday. Happily, we do have his partner Janet with us, and videos of some of her natural voice choirs, of which she will talk later. And I gather some of you in the choirs are there in the audience, so here's a wave and a thank you to Janet's choir people. But at very short notice, i.e. yesterday, I contacted some of my musician friends, and we indeed have three people with us to take over for, sadly, for Jim not being able to be with us. But we have Laura Ward and Adam Ronchetti and Julian Goodacre joining us. But I will be telling you more about them as the concert moves through. So I would just love to introduce you to two friends that I made last year in Brighton on a Hiroshima Day concert that Rob Johnson helped organise with their help. So I'm going to hand you over to Mike and Reina Reinstein, and I know they're wonderful performers. So over to Mike and Reina.
Thank you, Frankie. Hello, everybody. This first song I wrote a long time ago. It's called Gefällt mir mein Heim. And Gefällt mir mein Heim is Yiddish for I love my home. And the song is about my grandparents who fled persecution from Eastern Europe at the turn of the 20th century, and found sanctuary in this country. So this song is for them, but it's also for the people of Ukraine. It was many years ago, my grandparents left their home and they ended up so far away. They were gone. They were gone. Cossacks were at their heels. They left their family and all that they had known. They were on the run. They were on the run. In time they learned to live in their adopted land. It wasn't easy, but they survived. And through the ghetto years and later in suburbia, there was a suitcase packed in case they had to fly. Gefällt mir mein Heim, she said. Never spoke a word of English all of her life. All was gone. All was gone. And my granddad was a tailor. Died when my father was 15 years old. He was gone. He was gone. And though they died before I was born, I learned from their children to expect the Cossacks at my door. There's a suitcase in the hall. Well, you never know. They might come back the way they did before. Gefällt mir mein Heim. Gefällt mir mein Heim. I met God last night. He was lying on the street. There was a dog on a string, no shoes on God's feet. He was lying so still that I thought he was dead. Then he opened one eye, and here's what he said. The world could be a beautiful place. Forests, oceans, such a wonderful space. But who comes along to wipe the smile off my face? Then God took a swig from a bottle of Metz. He said, look at what's happening. No wonder I'm depressed. They're flooding the fields. They're burning the trees. They poison the air. They poison the sea. The world could be a beautiful place. Forests, oceans. Such a wonderful space, but who comes along to wipe the smile off my face? Mm-hmm. It's the human race, the human I blame myself, said God, it was such a big mistake. The tree of knowledge, the apple and the snake. And God took the dog and he held him in his arms. He said, you're good and kind, and you do no harm. Humans do what humans do. Humans could learn a lot from you. The dog turned and he looked at God. And this is what he said. Lord, much of what you say is true. But aren't humans made in the image of you? There's love and there's hate, there's truth and there's lies. Some humans are foolish, some humans are wise. And yes, the world is a beautiful place. Forests, oceans, such a wonderful space. God, in your mercy, are they so fallen from grace? Well, that's human race. Come on, Reina. Human race. Human race. Thank you. Hello, Reina.
Hi, Mike. Have you told them about the calf?
No, I haven't told them about the calf.
Last week, we were in a calf in London. And behind us in the booth, there were a lot of chatty noises and paper bustling. And we turned round and it was, you won't believe this, but it's true, Boris Johnson. And Boris Johnson kept saying, Evgeny, Evgeny, what else did he say?
He said, well, don't worry, Evgeny, it'll all be all right, just keep your head down, something like that.
And then after a bit, they got up and they walked out of the calf. And Boris was dancing about, he was very, very happy, singing this jolly song. And so, quick as a flash, I wrote the words down on a napkin. Mike remembered the tune, and we're going to do it for you now. Boris's song.
I got a blue sky, I got a twinkle in my eye, it's a beautiful day. Everything is going my way. I've done it all and I've had a ball. Just read my resume. Everything is going my way. And I don't even have to try. The days roll by, I'm a lucky little devil in the middle of a pork pie. I've got an automobile with golden wheels, it gets me from B to A. Everything is going my way. I got a new tuxedo, a dynamite libido. Well, that's what the papers say.
If it rains,
everything is going my way. And I don't even have to try.
Oh, what a guy.
The days roll by. I'm a lucky little Boris in the middle of a free time. And when I get to the end, and God says, friend, Boris, is there anything you wish to say in your defense before I pass judgment? God, you're mendacious but tussled little head. I'll say, everything is going, yeah, everything is going.
Such Duchess Vitimar.
Oh, thanks again. You're far too kind. Thank you.
Thank you.
In 1936, Oswald Mosley's black shirts marched in the streets of East London and were defeated and were sent packing by a fantastic demonstration. It was a great act of defiance and something that we're now used to, only extremely heroic and extraordinary Ukrainians. So this is a song for them. It's a song of defiance too. It's called On Cable Street. You're marching past the shops in our town, here in the land of hope and glory. You think you ought to rule Britannia, little England, you'll say, man. You've got something to say, what we hear loud and clear is your hands reaching out from the past. Your arms are straight and your faces are screaming what we heard before. From Buchenwald to Warsaw, flames climbing high on the Reichstag. You're burning all the books. So now, drums in your hands, boots on your feet, just remember what happened on Cable Street. Will you come again, wrapped in your flags like winding sheets? Every road you walk will be Cable Street. So whose turn is it now? Gonna be a bad one, 'cause when everything goes wrong, you gotta pin it on someone. Here comes somebody new. She looks different to you.
She'll do.
In your hands, boots on your feet, but just remember what happened on Cable Street. Will you come again, wrapped in your flags like winding sheets? Every road you walk will be Cable Street. And every road you walk, every road,
Okay, Reina's going to be on keyboards for this, and this is our last song, and I wrote this especially for this evening. Just have a sip of water. Yeah.
Don't push at the back there, gentlemen, ladies, there's plenty of room here inside. I've got modern solutions for mass executions. It's a service I'm glad to provide. A service I'm glad to provide. Hey, you in the front row, you're looking for answers to help you with your genocide. I've got Zyklon and Phosgene and Sarin and Bromine. It's a service I'm glad to provide. A service I'm glad to provide. There's always a threat. It's right under your bed. There's always an enemy, 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 enemy. Make way for the statesman, your national leader. His vanity, greed and his pride. He's not much of a ruler, so he wants to be crueler. That's a service I'm glad to provide. A service I'm glad to provide. So come in, sir, you're welcome. Now don't be so bashful, is there something you haven't yet tried? Why not nuclear fission to fry opposition? That's a service I'm glad to provide. A service I'm glad to provide. There's always a threat. It's right under your bed. It's always an enemy. Slaughter with blade or with mortar, I'm happy to be by your side. Nothing is sacred, well, nothing but hatred. It's a service I'm glad to provide. A service I'm glad to provide. There's always a threat. It's right under your bed. There's always an enemy, 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 enemy.
Thank you. Enjoy the rest of the evening.
Yay! Thank you.
Thank you, Mike and Reina. Oh, that last song is so chilling, given how recently the arms fair was here. Oh, thank you. Wonderful range of songs.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And now, lovely to have Janet with us. I'm sorry you're not feeling brilliant, Janet, but it's wonderful to have you and to have your choirs, who will be introduced to on video shortly. Janet and I have known each other for a very long time, both as singers, particularly of women's and political material, and the Natural Voice Network. So, Janet, please.
Thank you very much, Frankie. That's great. We sent six songs. We were so enthusiastic. And so Frankie had to make a selection, which is lovely. So we've got three songs coming up. The first one is called Ain't Gonna Study War, or Lay Down Your Sword and Shield, which I'm sure lots of you will be familiar with. But this is an arranged version for mixed choirs by Roxanne Smith, who is also a Natural Voice member and a really talented arranger. So this is sung by Settle Voices Community Choir. Some of them are definitely in tonight, so give us a wave. So the second one is by Silsden Singers, and it's Spring 1919 by Jim Boyes. He's written a lot of really wonderful, moving stuff about World War One. Jim has, and he moved to Flanders a few years ago, and he wrote this piece whilst walking through fields where some of the fiercest battles took place and where old ordnance is still found by farmers ploughing the fields. So the last one, which I'm really pleased we're able to do, was written by Penny Stone to celebrate the ratification of the nuclear ban treaty last year in January. 50 nations signed it at that point. Not Great Britain, of course. The UK doesn't do that sort of thing. We're still waiting for them to do that. So East Lancs Clarion Choir are singing this here in three parts. The nice thing about this one is you can add other bits if you feel like it. You can experiment while you're listening. East Lancs Clarion go out singing on for Burnley May Day Parade and Menwith Hill on the 4th of July, and they sing for the Chartists on Blackstone Edge every year. So they're a very committed political choir. So they're all community choirs. They come together without being auditioned, and they do a variety of different kinds of music. So here's the first one. This is Settle Voices singing Ain't Gonna Study War.
Ain't gonna study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. Gonna lay down your guns by the riverside. Ain't gonna study war.
Done, guys. So I've been working with Settle Voices since 2003. They're a great bunch. They change all the time. So the next one is Silsden Singers singing Spring 1919 by Jim Boyes.
The longest night of darkest dreams heralds a new tomorrow. The morning light, the bright sunbeams, can only soften sorrow. From deepest winter's harshest cold, there comes a hint of warming gold, and spring presents with tales untold the frozen earth to mourn.
Great song. When we were once at Menwith Hill on the 4th of July, the big listening post up in North Yorkshire, that one of the guys from Soldiers Against War was speaking there, and he had PTSD. It was very moving. It was almost too painful to watch him listen. PTSD is such a big and terrible thing, and I think that song calls it up quite well. So the next one is the one that was written for to celebrate the nuclear ban treaty by Penny Stone, and this is sung by East Lancs Clarion Choir in three parts, and it's the one that you can sing along with. Have a go.
Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned. Ring the bells to tell the whole world that the nuclear bombs have been banned.
Thank you, Janet.
Thank you.
Let's get Frankie back on. Well done, choirs.
Well done. Well done, everybody.
Thanks so much, Janet. Thanks, Sue, for your input, essential input too. And thank you to all the choir members who are here now and maybe will get a chance to see the concert in the future if they're not able to be here now. Thank you so much, Janet, and I hope you feel absolutely recovered miraculously very soon. And now I would... I'm so happy that Laura and Adam, with 24 hours virtually a notice, agreed that they would come and sing for us. I met them, oh God, 4 or 5 years ago now, I think. But it's only of recent years we've managed to spend some time and do some singing together. They are, as a duo, Hickory Signals, you may have heard, they've got CDs, and they're half of Bird in the Belly, a wonderful quartet. So over to Laura and Adam.
Thank you, Frankie. So good to be here. Hi, everybody. Thank you very much, Sue, for your hard work. We're going to start with a song called Kanya, which I wrote for a friend of mine, Kanya Mohammed, who came over from Syria. And I met him at a camp on the Greek island of Samos. And we got to know each other over the course of several weeks. And this song is a little bit about his experience. And I suppose rings true for the experiences, perhaps, of some of those that are coming over at the moment from Ukraine. So this is Kanya. Secretly, I've come to see that nothing good can come of me. I've gone so far on bad man's sin. You've shown no light nor let me in. I've come to see the waves again. You've shown no light. 5 more of me, my mortal kin. Without their bodies I've been. I've missed them then, I crave them now. A part of me is gone somehow. I long to see my face again. You've shown no light. Free me. Show me the light. I won't be. I refuse to live your fight. Tell me the hour and what's the day? 20 years ago was my birthday. That I've survived through years of hate. I have no will to celebrate. I long to see my place again. You've shown no light. Back then the earth was beauty grown. I loved it well, Malami, my home. And now they've torn it root by root. And we like scattered seeds are thrown. And how are we to grow in here? You've shown no light. Free me. Show me the light. I won't be your animal. I refuse to live your fight. On brighter days, strength suits me well. In darker times, this feels like hell. I'm more than here, I've lived a past. Give me my life and I'll make it last. I'm not seeking your sympathy. You've shown no light. Free me. Show me the light. I won't be your animal. I refuse to live your fight. Show me the light. I won't be your animal. I refuse to live your fight. Thank you very much. We're in the salubrious surroundings of the office that I work in on a day-to-day basis, so forgive the fire exit signs. That's not our chosen home decor. I'm going to do a song now called Paddy's Lament. And it's a traditional song, but I actually heard it sung by Sinead O'Connor, and that's the version that I've chosen to take on. And this is about the experience of an Irishman who emigrated to the States and then was called up to fight in the Civil War. Well, it's by the hush, me boys, and that's to mind your noise, and listen to poor Paddy's sad narration. I was by hunger stressed, and in poverty distressed. So I took a thought I'd leave the Irish nation. Well, I sold my horse and cow, my little pigs and sow, my father's farm of land, I then departed. And my sweetheart, Bid McGee, I'm afraid I'll never see. For I left her there that morning, broken-hearted. Hear ye, boys, now take my advice. To America I'll have yous not be coming. There is nothing here but war, where the murdering cannons roar. And I wish I was at home in dear old Dublin. Well, General Meyer to us he said, if you get shot or lose your head, every mother's son of yous will get a pension. Well, in the war I lost my leg, and all I've now's a wooden peg. By my soul it is the truth, to you I mention. Hear ye, boys, now take my advice. To America I'll have yous not be coming. There is nothing here but war, where the murdering cannons roar. And I wish I was at home in dear old Dublin. Well, myself and 100 more to America sailed o'er, our fortunes to be making, we were thinking. And when we got to Yankee land, they put guns into our hands, saying, Paddy, you must go and fight for Lincoln. Hear ye, boys, now take my advice. To America I'll have yous not be coming. There is nothing here but war, where the murdering cannons roar, and I wish I was at home in dear old Dublin. Well, I think myself in luck if I get fed on Indian buck, and old Ireland is the country I delight in, and to the devil I would say, God curse America, for in truth I've had enough of their hard fighting. Hear ye, boys, now take my advice. To America our have yous not be coming. There is nothing here but war, where the murdering cannons roar. And I wish I was at home in dear old Dublin. Thank you very much. We are going to do one last song for you, if that's okay. And we'll do a song that brings us a little bit of peace, not least because it has a bit of mouth trumpet in it. So forgive the mouth trumpet. I used to call it a mouth trombone, and then somebody heard us sing this song who was a trombonist, and he said, that's absolutely not a trombone. Never say that again. So now we call it a mouth trumpet, and no trumpet players have protested yet. So apologies if there are any on this evening. This is Unquiet Grave.
Today, listener, in a few small drops of rain. I never had but one true love in a cold grave she was lain. I'd do as much for my true love as any young man may. I'd sit and mourn all at her grave for 12 months and a day. 12 months and a day. 12 months and a day, being up the dead begin to speak. Oh, who sits weeping at my grave and will not let me sleep? 'Tis I, my love, sits on your grave and I will not let you sleep. For I crave a kiss of your clay-cold lips, and that is all I seek. That is all I seek. You crave a kiss of my clay cold lips, but my breath is earthy strong. And if I were to grant it you, your time would not be long. I know you're grieving for me, love, but you must tear away. Go cast your eye along the proof that time brings only change. Time brings only change. Down in yonder garden green, love, where we used to walk, the finest flower that e'er was seen is withered to a stalk.
The stalk is with a dry, my love, so will our hearts decay. Go make yourself content, my love, till God calls you away. Thanks so much for having us.
Oh, thank you for coming, Laura and Adam. That was beautiful. Thank you so much. And now to the other friend that I thought of when we suddenly found ourselves sadly without Jim. And there was a very specific reason that Julian Goodacre came to mind in the context of this concert, but I'll leave it to him to tell you why something I heard him play recently just brought him to mind for this event. So over to you, Julian.
Thank you, Frankie, and greetings to everyone from Scotland. Pat and I live in Peebles, just south of Edinburgh by the River Tweed. And but right now we're up in Killiecrankie, and Killiecrankie's got its own story of woe to tell. Last year, well, actually the year before last, our local people and district peace group decided to do something to mark January the 22nd, and we wanted to plant a tree, and we wanted to celebrate January the 22nd, the ratification of the United Nations treaty, and also to remember Peter Norris, who was a tireless campaigner for for peace and justice. So we decided to plant a tree by the River Tweed, and I managed to find a crabapple tree. I don't quite know why, but it was a rare variety from Melrose in the Borders. It's called Scrog. And so we bought that tree and planned to plant it on the 22nd. We've got a carillon in the church, so that it's going to play. We were going to play at 12 o'clock. The idea was throughout UK, hopefully throughout the world, bells would ring out, and we were going to celebrate that. And someone said to me, "Are you going to write a tune?" Now, I don't write tunes. I can't read music, but tunes come to me in the morning. So I thought, well, that's a good idea. Come up with a tune that is, I thought I'd better find one that's really grand and stirring and everything. Tunes don't work like that. So another tune came. I'll tell you more about it in a minute. I'm going to play it on the Leicestershire small pipes. I make bagpipes, that's what I do. I made over 300 of these or so. And this is the most special one I've made, because in August 1944, my Aunt Alice, who I never knew, was buried in the village in Leicestershire where I come from. And she and my grandfather, we presume, planted a cherry tree 2 yards away from her grave. So this is made of cherry from that very tree. So I, whenever I play this, I always tell people I'm playing my family tree. So we were gonna do a celebration for planting the tree, and I came up with this tune, and it was joyful, and it was optimistic and syncopated, and I thought, well, it's called the Peace Tree, and I would have loved to have had the silver band there with me, and the pipe band with me, and all the rest of it, but lockdown came, and you weren't allowed more than 2 people together, so it was Pat and me. Also, the ground was frozen solid, absolutely solid, so we never would have made a hole, so we brought the tree down. Little thing, it's not as tall as me even. We brought it down to see the spot, and the carillon tried to play my tune, The Peace Tree, and then the bells rang out, and then I played it. It was fiercely cold. It's nice and warm here where I am now. So now I'm going to play the Peace Tree.
Thank you, Julian, for the Peace Tree. I'm so glad that you were able to join us and play that for us. That was just beautiful. So it's now a chance for me to just say a little bit about Musicians for Peace and Disarmament, just to let those of you who maybe haven't come across us before. We actually, it started off in the early 80s as MANA, Musicians Against Nuclear Arms, and has changed its name more recently to MPD. And I've been lucky enough to be a patron since its beginning, and have felt extraordinarily privileged to be able to take part in and organise some concerts for them, because we're all about both producing a whole variety of music, the musicians involved, in the belief, the knowledge that music is central to being human. Simply, we are a musical animal. So to be able to utilize, that's not the right word, to share the music in order to promote peace and disarmament, I think is a wonderful combination. And we do have, apparently in the chat, there's the link for donations if anyone hasn't yet or would like to donate, because the money all goes to MPD, and then those of us on the committee choose which peace and disarmament organisations the money will go to. And for example, last year we sent quite a bit to CND, Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament, that we have a close relationship with, and CAAT, the Campaign Against the Arms Trade. So that was so fitting, Mike, your song about that. We've sent money to an organisation called PAL, which is a music school for young musicians in Gaza, in Israel, and, well, Palestine. We've sent some money to the Women's Peace Organization that was one of the first organizations to really start the peace process in Northern Ireland. So you would look at and think about a wide range of organizations to decide. And obviously there's increased need now for refugee organizations. So thank you to anyone who has donated for us. Now it's my turn to sing just a couple of songs, well, maybe three short songs, after wetting my whistle. This first one was written by a dear friend and a great inspiration, Peggy Seeger, and it's called How I Long for Peace. And when I'm going to sing that, I'm going to repeat it for you to come and join me. I know we won't be able to hear any of you, sadly, but it is just such a beautiful phrase. And even though I can't see you due to my lack of sight, not lack of vision, I trust, but it'll be lovely for you to have that sense of literally around the world, people joining in with How I Long for Peace. And Darian will just help me on the shruti. How I long for peace amongst the peoples and the nations. How I long to halt the plunder of the wonders of creation. Oh, how I long for peace. Oh, how I long for peace. I cannot understand why the sisters, wives and mothers cannot stop the slaughter of their husbands, sons and brothers. Oh, how I long for peace. Oh, how I long for peace. There never can be peace. Why, till men abandon fighting as the way of solving problems that prevent us from uniting. Oh, how I long for peace. Oh, how I long for peace. The profits made from war, there are few that can resist them. Hypocrisy and greed control the lifeblood of our system. Oh, how I long for peace. Oh, how I long for peace. The earth can wait no longer for political permission. Sit down, disrupt, do anything to make the whole world listen. Oh, how I long for peace amongst the peoples and the nations. How I long
come to halt the plunder of the wonders of creation. Oh, how I long for peace. Yes, oh, how we long for peace.
And can I, a couple of people weren't muted. It was lovely to hear.
Yes.
The occasional other, but for this next lullaby, I would like everybody to mute themselves. This is just a short, I've taken a couple of verses and the refrain of a Highland lullaby that was originally in Gaelic, and this is just a translation from the Gaelic. It's a lament. Clearly, lullabies have been used as laments, celebrations, storytelling, all kinds of reasons, as well as hoping a baby will go to sleep. But I wanted to include this just as a lament. Hoven, hoven, garia ho, garia ho, garia ho, hoven, hoven, garia ho. I never found my baby, oh. I left my baby lying there, lying there, lying there. I left my baby lying there and went to pick some blaberries. I saw the swan's nest by the loch, by the loch, by the loch. I saw the swan's nest by the loch, but I never found my baby, oh. I heard the curlew crying far, crying far, crying far. I heard the curlew crying far, but I never found my baby, oh. Hoven, hoven, goria ho, goria ho, goria ho. Hoven, hoven, goria ho. I never found my baby, oh. And now I'll sing something that I did write for a celebration, because this year is the 40th anniversary of the encompassing of the base at Greenham Common. I know some of you would have been there, and I thought I'd like to write a song that encompassed the actions of the Greenham women, but other women too at other times. But for tonight, I'm just picking three verses that do relate to the Greenham actions. And in fact, the starting of that 41 years ago, the march that started from Cardiff, which is where I am, 41 years ago, when Women for Life on Earth walked, set up the peace camp. So this is, I'm going to stand because it starts off with my saying, we went marching from Wales, where I am. So it seems more fitting that I stand for that. So I hope I'm still in view.
Yep.
And there are bits that I'm sure you'll just pick up and join in any way that you can. There isn't time for me to teach you the chorus, sadly, but I'm sure you'll find a way of joining in. So it's, I've called it, Here's What We Women Can Do. And obviously I incorporate the men who were supportive of the Green and Peace actions too, so. We went marching from Wales with anger and love. Here's what we women can do. The land of the raven, the land of the dove. Here's what we women can do. Sing to all nations, we must strive for peace. Ban weapons of war, demand that they cease. Here's what we women can do. However many, however few, we must be the voice for our one Mother Earth. Bring home to our it's a bit late for me. Bring home to our home what our planet is worth. Here's what we women can do.
Held hands.
We held hands in a circle. We danced in a ring. Here's what we women can do. We encompassed 9 miles and the world heard us sing. Here's what we women can do. We sliced through the wires. We dreamed of new worlds, not made of straight lines, but
spirals.
But spirals and swirls. Here's what we women can do. However many, however few, we must be the voice for our one Mother Earth. Bring home to our home what our planet is worth. That's what we women must do. Yes, that's what we women must do. We never were silenced, not even in court. Here's what we women can do. Our suffragette sisters inspired our retort. Here's what we women can do. Imprisoned for crying, no more weapons of war. With the murder of millions enshrined in our law. Here's what we women must do. However many, however few, we must be the voice for our one Mother Earth. Bring home to our home what our planet is worth. That's what we women must do. Yes, that's what we women must do. I'm sorry. It's actually, I'm still in the process of writing it, so it's work in progress. Now I have an absolute treat to introduce to you our last performer. I met him first, I reckon it was about 33 years ago, something like that, over 30 years ago, at a folk festival in Australia, when we were both performing there. And I've been to visit to see him for live on a number of occasions since. And now I'm just so looking forward to handing over to Rory McLeod to bring this amazing concert to a suitable close. Take it over, Rory.
Thank you. Thanks, Frankie. Hi, everyone. Hello from Scotland. I'm not far from where Julian lives. I'm not far from Hoyk, the Scottish borders here. So I'll probably do four songs, and hopefully the last one you might be able to sing along somehow together. I'll teach you as I sing the song, maybe. But I'm very happy to talk with people I disagree with. I just wanted to say that. Talking about war, and the only war I can think, let's have war on poverty, not the Middle East. And the enemy, the real enemy, is poverty and austerity, and those who impose it on us. So, and there can't be any peace without justice. Look, I guess it's the arm manufacturers, the gun manufacturers. There's lots of corruption there. I can see the corruption there. The NRA, the National Rifle Association, is run by gun manufacturers. It felt to me as if the NRA might have been the military wing of Trump's Republican Party. They donated, the NRA donated millions to his election campaign. But only last week, March the 13th, was the memorial of the Dunblane massacre. On this day in 1996, 16 children were massacred and a teacher. And I'm going to sing a song somehow that covers that kind of thing. There was shootings in Florida. That changed the gun laws. The Dunblane massacre changed the gun laws. So now outlawing private ownership of most handguns. And 200,000 gun owners had to hand their guns in. And I sang this song March the 13th, was my dad's birthday, which I remember it as well. It's my mum's birthday today. It would have been my mum's birthday today as well, but anyway. But I sang it, March the 13th was the Dunblane massacre, 26 years ago. But 3 years ago, just after that, there was the, New Zealand, there was a shooting in Christchurch, outside a mosque. This song is about tools, really, and I'll try and remember it. I use a broom to sweep the dust off the floor. I use wooden oars to row my boat to shore. To pull bent nails, use my grandpa's pliers. Pine cone for kindling and flint for starting fires. I use a fork to turn the earth, I use a trowel to sow. Seedlings, gooseberry bushes to grow. Garlic, chives, rhubarb, apples and plums. But I've never had any use for a gun. Banging in a nail, hanging a picture, fix your shelf. I've used a bed sheet for a sail. I've used a screwdriver for screwing bits of wood together. Use my hat and coat to keep out the cold and windy weather. I've used a pencil to draw and a pen to write a letter to send greetings and news to everyone. But after all this time, my itchy fingers still find that they don't have any use for a gun. I use a bucket to carry water from the well. I use a pot for tea and coffee. I love that smell. I use my bone shaker of a truck to lug around my tools. That same old banger takes my kids to school. I use a knife for slicing bread to share with everyone. I use the blade for cutting tethers that couldn't be undone. But as yet, I've never felt any threat nor terror nor had any use for a gun. Can to order my crops. I use a wood plane to chisel that were our grandpops. Our chores are never finished, that we weren't non-stop. I built a bread that we can dream and when we're ready to flop. I use an umbrella for the rain, a sombrero for the sun. My way of life has brought me to my belief in everyone. My beliefs and my ideas are a little homespun. But we've learned to make demands, yet be patient where we're from. And we've never had any use for a gun. use a pot to fry beans, use a pan. A glove to stop me getting thorns and splinters in my hand. I've used a bandage to stop bleeding from a gash that left me scarred. Use scissors and glue to make a birthday card. I used a railway train to bring me somewhere far. To trouble the song that might be using this guitar. Used a ball to throw the catch and to kick and have fun. Use old guitar strings to tie a loose exhaust pipe on. After all the tools I've handled and all the wrenches I've wielded, and the poisonous ideas I've avoided and I've shunned, after all these years, despite pressure from my peers, I still find I have no use for a gun. There'll be no need for a gun to protect ourselves from someone else with a gun, or defending themselves from someone with a gun, or guarding themselves from a man who's scaring himself and frightening everyone else with a gun. I've used Spanish expressions, learned to speak another tongue. These are the words to talk in places where I ain't from. With other people who are patient, who make me feel that I belong. And wherever I've travelled, wherever I've gone, I was welcomed, I wasn't rejected or snubbed. My hand was shaken, I wasn't beaten or clubbed by anyone. I made acquaintances and friends, luck brought us together, and we were introduced, or maybe friends. I found I've never had any use for a gun. I recall my grandma's old valve radio, when Gunslinger and the Oakley sung. How she danced and her sweet voice soared. I remember that song with Betty Hutton roared. With passion and with power, I heard my own mother even sing it in the shower. That you can't get a man with a gun. I've killed midges, killed a wasp, I've killed aphids on my radish. I'll kill flu, germs and bacteria. I guess that means I'm not a Buddhist. I'm peaceful, I've never meant harm to anyone. If by surprise I find myself looking down the muzzle of a gun. In fights I use my fist, though first I try to use my tongue. Some will bully you for power, some will spite you just for fun. It's good to be brave, but then it's also good to run. I aim to die in my sleep, age 101. Brother, can I try to persuade you with your patience wearing thin? But to fight a war, we all will lose, a war no one can win. Can I ask you please to put down that rifle? I've heard that some folks will kill you for an idea or a trifle. I'm sure we can all agree to differ and end up somehow shaking hands. I try to listen to your worries, your fears and your demands. I've got boundaries, you've got frontiers, we've both got our border lines. These can change like the wind, always being redefined. Prejudice is taught, young children aren't that way inclined. I'm asking you to try to see that hatred makes us blind. I'm asking you to try to look, to try to aim a little higher. I'm inviting you to sit and eat and talk around our fire till we all find we don't have any use for a gun. Thanks a lot. Cheers. Yes. Well, I won't talk too much. I always blather a lot when I'm singing, and not that I've sung much lately. But I'll just get on. This song is I made when the West, we were supposed to be trying to bring democracy to Iraq. I say we. I think we went over there to fight for Exxon half the time, and a bit like we maybe American. Brought democracy. Well, they didn't like democracy in Chile, the way it worked, because it kind of worked against the mining companies there and the Rio Tinto Zincs, because they when Salvador Allende was president after many years, started giving the land back to Indians and nationalizing and kicking the mining companies out. They didn't like that, so that terrorist group, the CIA, they overthrew the government and put Pinochet in. Great friend of Mrs. Thatcher's. I think she would have had tea with him. She probably would have had tea with Colston, the slave owner, probably. He would have probably been a Tory party donator. Anyway, look, this song is called No Blood for Oil. I was asked to play some harmonica. I don't normally play on this song, but I'm going to try and play some harmonica for you on this song. I guess this was, I had a brother-in-law that was in the army, and he was out there in Iraq and wondering what they were fighting out there for. I'll just get on with the song anyway. They seem to have, in Kuwait, they were invaded, but no, you know, and sorry, not in Kuwait, in, I'm trying to remember that town now. Basically, there was a country that was invaded that we didn't help because they didn't seem to have any oil under their land. They seem to have, whereas in Iraq, seem to have our oil under their land. So anyway, I'll get on with this. Here we go. Becoming fists, we've heard of the alienation tango, the waltz and the twist, but to dance is a dance without a partner, and it's called the self-hypnosis. No more blood for oil, no more killing for those oil corporation outlaws. It's you, not us, we're not disturbing the peace, but we are disturbing the war. Your kids play cowboys and Hollywood Indians, television cops and outlaws, while in the Middle East, far away from your living room, children are dying in real wars, bleeding real blood. Look at them burn, look at them burn. Napalm burns fast, they're burning faces, frightened and scarred on our kids' Halloween masks. This is not television, war is not our decision, and we accept no command. Someone with a gun has stolen our home, someone with a tank is taking our land. No more blood for all, no more killing for those oil corporation outlaws. It's you, not us, we're not disturbing the peace, but we are disturbing the war. To shoot to 12,000 miles behind the wire, sitting in your armchair far away from the screams, the blood and the guts and the gunfire, giving the orders and answering those who refuse to shoot because they cannot and because you suspect a mutinous plot. You are screaming, those soldiers who refuse to shoot will be shot. Those who refuse to shoot, them who refuse to shoot will be shot. Those who refuse to shoot, them who refuse to shoot, those who refuse to shoot will be shot by friendly fire. Bullets singing like a choir, friendly fire. A peace has gone haywire with friendly fire. An enemy is not required, an unfriendly fire with no umpire. What is fair in love and war, but love is not required. All is fair in love and war, but love is not required. You've heard on the alienation tango, the waltz and the twist, but your dance is a dance without a partner, and it's all the self-hypnosis. No more blood for Roma or Kelly, for those oil corporation it was. It's you, not us. We're not disturbing the peace, but we are disturbing the war. I got more blood for Roma or Kelly, for those rich corporation at laws. It's you, not us. We're not disturbing the peace, but we are disturbing the war. God bless Enron. Thank you. I make songs. It's nice to hear about Cable Street earlier. My grandma came from Ukraine, from Chitima. She was a little baby when she left, when she was brought over to be brought up in East London, Whitechapel, near Cable Street. And it turns out, cut a long story short, one of my uncles, my great uncle, her brother, my uncle Joe, was a wrestler, an amateur wrestler, and I found out much later by meeting someone in New Zealand by chance, he was a vigilante at Cable Street to stop the black shirts from coming. Black shirts, Oswald Mosley, who was supported by the owner of the Daily Mail at the time, Lord Rothermere. The first thing to die in war seems to be truth, and newspapers, and there's what the, we don't hear much about Palestine these days, or Syria. I mean, they should have sanctions against Israel for things that are bombing that's been going on. But this song is about most people who join the army. It seems when I was a kid, our friends who joined the army and ended up in Northern Ireland, but they come from poor people, poor backgrounds a lot of the time. And the way the army works, it's quite well. You get the top class, the top knobs up the top, and you get the people shining their click, putting their litter out at the bottom. And anyways, a whole. It's the way they like to see the rest of society, I think, the way that armies are reflected in things. Anyway, there won't be much peace without justice. This is a song about a farming woman called A Farming Woman's War. And you hear by the chorus it was during Vietnam, but I think it's still, I'll see if I can, I'm changing the key here. I'll see if I can do it in this key for a change. Anyway. Our hollow home, the roads are getting wider. Since those highways started rolling us down, our old horse ain't had no rider. Well, housework and farming is all ever done before, working 18 hours. Sleeping, I was outdoors, stuck in fodder by the moonlight. I'll never rest it even on a Sunday, and we always kept a good fire alight. I had to cook for 10 kids, I had 11 kids, but I raised 10. My life's been hard, I know, but what I to live it all over again. We all talk about what they've done to us. They dig our land and leave slate and dust. We're the poorest people on the richest land. Our grandpa signed two crosses and gave the right to some company man. Papers, and they told Grandpa, sign here. It was like he signed his will, because they brought their drills and tore the land up everywhere. They sent our boys off to fight for freedom, for freedom in Vietnam. But freedom for who? It's war at home, bear two again. Company. Lisa Nelson, $75 for her farm. $5 billion, and now they've got legal rights. Their coal mining killed my uncles and brothers, and their army sent my sons up to fight. They sent their boys up to fight for freedom, for freedom in Vietnam. But freedom for who? It's war at home here too. Vegetables to get to their coal and their oil. They want to dig up a cemetery too, where grandpa's buried. They say there's coal under his grave. They say the coal's necessary. The preacher's wife is buried there too, and so is Mrs. Harrison's niece. They want to dig the whole lot up. They won't even let the dead rest in peace. They send our boys off to fight for freedom, freedom in Vietnam. But freedom for who? It's war at home here too, against the company and the banks, and defending our land. And you can't talk to them, because they just walk off and leave you, and they know that they're doing wrong. And soon they might start taking anything they want. And soon I might have to get out my gun. They send our boys off to die for freedom, for freedom in Vietnam. But freedom for who? It's war at home here too, against the company and the banks, and defending our land. They send our boys off to die for freedom, freedom in Vietnam. But freedom for who? It's war at home here too, against the company and defending our land and everything else in the community. Everyone's thank you. I've got one more. I'll teach you this one. It's an old one. I made up when Mrs. Thatcher there was war with Argentina. Mrs. Thatcher declared war with Argentina. Ironically, we sell arms to the Saudi Arabia. We sell arms to anyone who buy them, really. The only side that arms manufacturers seem to be on is the side of profit. That's how I see it anyway, and that seems the way it is. Mrs. Thatcher sold weapons to Galtieri, Argentinian's dictatorship. And 3 days later, they were using them against British soldiers. Ironically, it's like selling someone a brick to throw you through your window or something like that, I don't know. Or employing a glazer to do the same thing. But it's good for the arms trade. I was reading a business news headline that said arms manufacturers tell investors that Iran tension fuels business. So it's good. So anyway, look, I've always believed traveling in Latin America, well, Central America mostly, but all the people I met, I ended up believing that the British people and the Argentinian people had the same enemies. And they were our governments, basically, at the time. That's how I felt, anyway. And over the Falklands, which are the Malvinas, really. Like Isle of Wight. Yeah, anyway. Oh, this is what you might sing. I'm just going to sing the song, and I'll give you a hint when I sing it, what you could sing when it goes along. It's called Passing the Pain Down. And I hope I've got time for this. No one's told me to stop it, so I guess this is my last song, just in case if you're wondering. And it's, what else can I say? There's so many things I could say, but I won't bother. I did wonder what ever happened to the Israeli whistleblower Mordecai Vanunu. He was a nuclear, because Israel's been stockpiling nuclear weapons for a while. Shouldn't there be sanctions against Israel, as there have been against Iran? I'm wondering these kind of things. I don't know, double standards, you know. Israel have been bombing Palestine, like Russia have been bombing Ukraine. I don't know. Don't get me wrong. I'm just wondering. I don't want any war anywhere, except to say against poverty. But anyway, here we go. Oh, I don't need that, do I?
Taking us round the world with you, just so, what a journey the whole evening.
It's been a lovely evening. Lovely to hear everyone singing. Thank you for having us, Frankie, and thanks, Sue.
Oh, thanks for coming, everybody. it's
It's just been such a special evening and just such a range of wonderful, wonderful music. So please stay well, stay safe, go in peace. Let us try and, I mean, music seems to me, singing seems to be one of the things that allows us to keep energy, and energy allows us to keep active and hoping. So those are the thoughts I leave you with, and thank everybody for coming, obviously particularly the performers and particularly Sue, who made it all possible. So good night.